One of the key things then is that when we're looking at students who are English learners developing their English language skills, that is going to significantly affect their ability to perform on academic content assessments that are given in English, as most are. And so we really need to understand what students' levels of English language proficiency are when we test them in order to have an idea about what kinds of interference could be occurring for those students and to try and accommodate them in those needs that they have. So one big point then is that we really have to think about if our assessments don't take into account our English learners' levels of language proficiency, then we're going to be unclear when their results come back, whether we're looking at if performance is less than expected, what is interfering with that performance? Is it their level of English language proficiency? Is it access to quality academic content instruction or the opportunity to learn content? Is it their you know, lack of knowledge in the content area? Or could it be some other construct irrelevant, as we call it, interference from the way that the assessment is asking the student to display knowledge or perform that may be confusing the student and they're not really understanding what's being asked. There's two key points that they should take away from the paper. One is that there's going to need to be a lot more collaboration between those who are really focused on students' language development and those who are focused on their academic content development. And in fact, those kinds of disciplines and interests and pedagogical approaches are going to need to become much more integrated. And so every teacher is going to really think about the disciplinary language and ensure that students really have opportunities to engage in that. With respect to our assessments, we really want folks to think about formative assessment as being one of the key resources. And by that I don't mean item banks and small tests, but really to think about the instructional processes and practices and the tools that can actually give teachers instructionally relevant information during the act of instruction. This is really at the heart of formative assessment, so that those kinds of practices become intertwined with what their pedagogical approaches are and can give them information to help improve students' learning in the act of teaching.